spend time for waiting for Nahal.
Is my voice clear now?
Yes, very clear. Good.
Alright, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. We are from Minerva Group, group of three. And the main topic that we're going to discuss is the final decision about are we going to do the mid test by online, offline, or we mix it? And maybe as the opener, I will give to Tasha as the author. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Hadi. So, good morning, Bapak, Ibu. Here we are due to the pandemic condition. We have this meeting online again, but I hope it will running smoothly. So, can you hear my voice?
Yes, I can.
Thank you. Let's start. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The Honorable, the Principal of Minerva High School, Mr. Fauzi, and the Honorable Vice Principal of Minerva High School, Mr. Hadid, and the Honorable staff and the teachers of Minerva High School. So in this morning, allow me, Tasha, as the assistant of academic affairs and curriculum to be the host for this meeting, which is midterm preparation of Minerva High School. Before we start to the main session, let me deliver the structure or the agenda of our meeting today, which is the opening, second remarks, third is our meeting, our discussions, and the fourth is the conclusion, fifth closing. So let's open this meeting by reciting Basmalah together.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
All right. Let's move to the second agenda is a remarks that will be delivered by our principal to Mr. Fauzi. Please, time is yours.
All right. Thank you, Tasha. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. Honorable Vice Principal, Honorable Assistant Principal of Academic Affairs and Curriculum, General Assistant Principal of School Finance and Operation, General All Teacher, General Assistant Principal of Student Affairs. First of all, let us express our gratitude to the presence of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has given us His mercy and grace so that we can gather from the midterm examination Minerva High School meeting 2021 or 2022 academic year. And the second time, we continue to send salawat and greeting to the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with the accompaniment of prayers. Hopefully, later on the last day, we will still be among the believers. Thank you to the all staff, teacher who took the time to attend this meeting. I hope that in this meeting, a satisfactory decision will be reached for of us for the midterm examination. Thank you. I give to back Miss Tasha.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Fauzi, for your valuable remarks. So let's move to the main session or to the main agenda, which is the meeting or the discussion, I mean. So I will give this to Mr. Hadid to handle our meeting. Mr. Hadid, please, I'll give it to you.
All right, thank you, Ms. Meita, for the opportunity. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin, we could reassemble again in this beautiful morning. And as we have heard before, the main topic or the main issues that we're going to discuss is about I mean, are we going to do the mid test by online, by offline, or we will mix it? So, okay, listening to this issue, I think it would be perfect to listening the point of view from students of FAIR. There is Miss Ramadanti, it is in this room. Hello, Miss Ramadanti.
Hello, Mr. Hadid.
Okay, could you please give your opinion or your suggestion about this issue, Ms. Ramadanti?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Hadid, for giving me the time. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. I'm Friskanis, the assistant principal of students. I want to report that we have conducted a survey regarding to this to the students, which were carried out 1 week before the meeting via the Google Form link that has been distributed to each class. And wait, I will share the results. Have you seen the screen?
Almost.
Almost.
How about now?
Yeah, I can see.
Yes, we can see.
Yeah, as you can see in the screen, based on the survey results, that 77.3% of students are ready to take the online midterms, complete with the facilities they have, such as cell phones and the good quality of networks. And 22.7% of students are not ready to take the online midterms due to the unstable network of its students. I'm afraid that it will hinder students when working on questions or sending the answers. So yeah, maybe that's all I can report. I will return it to Mr. Hadid. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, students of FAIR, for your explanation. And as we can see from the diagram that you have just shared, more than 50% of the students are ready to do mid test by online, but we still have to listen about from the teacher, from the other teacher's opinion. Okay, is anyone want to give suggestions or feedbacks?
May I? Hello, Mr. Nahal, can you hear my voice?
Yes, I can.
Okay. I'm totally agree with what Ms. Ramadanti said, because in this pandemic, especially in our country, although the cases are decreasing, the virus with the new variants, and it's always present, and of course, it becomes something more sinister. To reduce worries and reduce the higher risk, we should do the exam online. Maybe we can work around with a different question for each other, I mean each students, to avoid the cheating. And with exam online, we don't have worry that students will be exposed to coronavirus, and we have to be patient and refrain from going out. And so the coronavirus chains can also be broken. That's all. I'll be back to Mr. Nahal. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Ms. Habiba, for explanation. I'm sorry because I was having trouble with my connections. And okay, thank you once again, Ms. Habiba. Is there anyone else want to give your opinion?
May I?
Okay, please, Ms. Amarlani.
Okay, yeah, okay, thank you to Mr. Hadid. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, good morning, everyone. And by the way, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to deliver my opinion about this discussion. And here, I'd like to confirm to Ms. Ramadanti about the survey that has been conveyed by you just now, that maybe 77% of the students are ready to take the midterm online. Is it right?
Yeah, that's right. Most students are ready to take the online exams.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Ramadanti. So, from me, if we look back at the survey that has conducted by Ms. Ramadanti, that the majority of students are ready to take the midterm online, so that inevitably the midterm will be held online. And besides that, because of the students' readiness is the most important thing in carrying out the midterm online. So I really agree if the midterm will be held online. And also besides that, I couldn't more agree with Ms. Habiba's statement just now that, yeah, we are still in COVID-19 situation. So maybe one of us, one of the students, one of the teachers, still afraid if the midterm will be held online. Yeah, maybe that's all from me. Thank you, and I will give it back to Ms. Hadid. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Ms. Nida and Ramadlani, for your opinion. And yeah, I totally agree that students' readiness is the most important thing that we could consider in this situation. And yeah, as far as we've heard the teachers' opinion, all of them are agree with the online mid test that we're going to conduct, but we could not decide it yet. So let's just now listen from point of view from the operational and finance schools. There is Mr. Al-Kamil. Mr. Rizal, please.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Mr. Nahal. Maybe from finance and operation, for the internet network at school, it's very stable and we have also upgraded. Initially, the internet speed was around 100 Mbps. Now it is 50 Mbps. We also continue to monitor the speed of the internet network in school. Maybe enough from me. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Al-Kamil. And listening to the explanation from school operational and financial, is there anyone want to give their feedback or response? From Mr. Kunia, maybe? I want to hear your opinion.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Hadid. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. I have permission to express my opinion. In my opinion, if the midterm exams were conducted virtually online and offline, there might be many students who agree because offline students would feel disadvantaged. If done online, I'm sure the students will also try to be able to take the exam. And if it is done offline, can the school guarantee the health of students in the midst of this pandemic? Because even though the number of COVID-19 has decreased, it is possible for it to spread again. If it will be done offline, I have a suggestion. What if students are divided into to take offline exams in the morning and afternoon? Maybe that's all from me. I'll give it back to Mr. Hadid. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Kunia, for your opinion. And yeah, I couldn't agree more. We teachers, school could not guarantee the students' health in these situations, even though the cases of the virus has decreased. Okay, maybe as a final decision or as a final result, let's just hear from our headmaster opinion from Mr. Fauzi. Hello, Mr. Fauzi.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Hadid, for your affinity, and thank you to all staff and all teachers for your suggestion and feedback. And here I would like to convey it's better if we do the midterm examination online, because it's for the safety to of all teacher, student, and other staff, even though the situation has improved. Maybe there is a guarantee that all teacher, student, and other staff have carried out the vaccine. So I decided to take the midterm exam online, but on the condition that the students do not plagiarize. Thank you. I give the back to Mr.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Headmaster, for your suggestions. And now we actually forgot about the rest of the survey that just conducted from Students Affair. It is about the students who are not ready yet from the online learning. What solution that we could give, what solution that we could make for these solutions? Is there anyone that want to give your solution about this issue?
All right. Can you hear my voice, Mr. Hadid?
Yes.
But, all right. Thank you for mentioning about the rest of our students. But I think I want to say something, but sorry, due to the poor connection, I think I have to turn off my camera. So from the data of Ms. Ramadlanti, right, about 77% ready to do the online midterm, and then the rest, which is the 23% of them are not ready. So we have to consider about the rest of them. Like, we also need to find a solution for them. And I think as a teacher, maybe we can give them the tolerance, like for them to submit their work a little bit late. But of course, the instructions is still clearly we instruct our students to submit the work on time, but if some of them they have as we know from the survey, they have a trouble with their connection, so it's okay for them to a little bit late. Maybe that's the suggestion that I can give to the teachers here, to give your students tolerance about the time to submit their work, their results of the midterm. So maybe that's from me. Yeah, I'll give it back to Mr. Hadid, please.
All right, thank you, Ms. Meita, for your solutions. Yeah, I totally agree, because the best solution that we can give for this issue is giving tolerance. What else that we can give from the low connections issue? Is the other teachers agree with what Ms. Taisa said?
Yeah, I totally agree.
Yes, I couldn't more agree with Tasha's solution, because I think that's the best solution.
All right. Thank you for your response. And maybe it is fixed that the final decisions or the final result of our meeting today is the mid-test will be held online. Okay, maybe it's time for me to sign out. I'm sorry for all my mistakes that I made during this meeting. Thank you. And for the closing, I will give it back to Ms. Meita. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Hadid. So, ladies and gentlemen, the teachers of Minerva High School, we come out to the end sessions. But before I close this, let me convey the conclusion of our meeting that finally we will hold the midterm online due to the survey that 77% of students, like let's consider like 80%, and the rest is the 20% is not ready, but we also come up with the solutions that less tolerance them, all right? But still the instruction is to turn on the result of the midterm on time. So maybe that's for our meeting today. Thank you so much to Bapak Ibu, the Minerva High School teachers to coming to our meeting today. I am Tasha Mehta. I will sign out. Thank you so much. I hope that we are always healthy to always teach our students. Thank you so much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you.
All right, you may leave the meeting room. Thank you.
Okay. Yep. Thank you so much. Wow. Congratulations, Group Minerva. Okay, such a really great show. Ini international school ya? Ayah, tapi sebelumnya ini Lauren sedang kena musibah ya teman-teman ya. Lauren belongs to this group ya. Kayaknya meninggal. Innalillahi wa inna ilaihi rajiun. Mari sebelum kita melanjutkan aktivitas, sejenak kita berdoa dulu untuk kakek Lauren yang telah meninggalkan Lauren dan keluarga selama-lamanya. Kita doakan semoga amal baik beliau diterima di sisi Allah, diampuni segala dosa-dosanya, dan keluarga yang ditinggalkan diberi ketabahan. Kita semua bisa mengambil pelajaran dari setiap kematian tentunya ya. Sebaik-baiknya pelajaran dan juga pengingat itu adalah pemutus kenikmatan, yaitu mati. Ya. Doakan teman-teman. Doa terbaik untuk beliau. Baik, untuk Lauren nanti ada sesi khusus, kita berikan excuse untuk pertemuan kali ini. Nanti ada tugas yang lain ya, dibantu oleh teman-teman sekelompok, terutama Mr. Hadid. Baik, saya langsung ke feedback saja ya.
Excuse me, Mom.
Ya, gimana, Syah?
Yeah, but Lauren is not our... bukan anggota dari Minerva, Ibu.
Sorry, Artemis ya?
Iya, ya, Ibu.
Sorry. Intan berarti ya. Nanti Intan akan bantu untuk handle tugas untuk Lauren. Okay, kita akan sambut kelompok ini dengan tepuk tangan yang meriah sekali. Yang pertama, ya, congratulations. Karena I was so impressed, sangat terkesan dengan data yang disajikan. Itu yang membuat saya paling terkesan dari penampilan Anda. Halo, suara saya terdengar tidak? Kayaknya losing connection. Ya, jadi memang kenapa Dika? Dika raising hand?
Oh, hey, buat tepuk tangan.
Sorry Kak. Ya, Dika gave you applause. All right. Thank you Dika. Ya, tepuk tangan itu ya. Ya, jadi yang pertama yang paling impresifnya itu adalah data ya, karena memang sometimes it is really important in decision making. Jadi penampilan yang sudah ditampilkan itu sudah international based school banget ya. Jadi kalau international school itu kalau mau mengambil keputusan itu pasti berbasis data ya. Indonesian juga beberapa ada yang mengikuti, sudah mulai mengikuti begitu. Tapi ya terkadang kalau di perkampungan seperti kita di sini itu nggak ada gitu. Yang ngambil data sebar Google Form, apalagi ke anak yang masih young learners gitu ya. Ini sekolahnya apa levelnya, SD, SMP, SMA?
High school,
SMA. Ya, kalau high school, ya kalau high school memang sudah pantas untuk di sebar Google Form ya. Kalau untuk yang middle schools ataupun elementary itu rasanya Google Form belum terlalu work gitu, dan semua decision-nya yang sudah diputuskan bagus sekali. Terus ada satu hal lagi yang tadi saya garis bawahi itu menyoal addressing name ya. Culturally, secara budaya memang di target culture ya khususnya British, American, Australia, and other countries playing English as first language, itu addressing nama itu ketika kita pakai Mr. dan Miss dan Mrs. itu memang nama belakang ya. So you are supposed to address me as Miss Hidayat, Mrs. Hidayati actually. Dan teman-teman secara budaya sudah menerapkan itu secara target culture ya, budaya bahasa aslinya. Tadi sudah disebut Mr. Hadid, Miss Damayanti, Ramadanti, and then Miss Ramadlani, and so on and so forth. Dan itu sudah bagus sekali, berarti sudah aware banget ya intercultural awareness-nya. Dan tapi sekali lagi kalaupun ada yang masih manggil Miss Nidaan, Miss Tasya, itu enggak apa-apa karena itu sudah menjadi serapan budaya target culture oleh kita ya, oleh bahasa Indonesia. Jadi mau pakai Mr. Ahmad, ya nggak apa-apa kayak gitu juga. Dan itu sudah menjadi kekhasan dari Indonesian English gitu ya. Kita nggak bisa memaksain kayak, hey Mr. Fauzi, malah lupa ya nama saya Fauzi gitu ya. Padahal sehari-harinya dipanggil Mr. Ahmad gitu. Jadi ada dua hal yang saya garis bawahi. Your cultural awareness sangat bagus sekali terhadap target culture tentang addressing name in a formal meeting. Itu bagus banget. Oke, sekarang saya tanya dulu nih, gimana persiapan-persiapan yang dilakukan, idenya dari mana, lalu bagaimana perasaannya, siapa yang mau coba sharing persiapannya dulu?
Sebenarnya persiapan kami bisa dibilang sangat mendadak, Ibu.
Okay.
Hanya H-2 atau H-3 gitu. Dan itu pun saat malam hari. Dan Okay. Kita semua tahu kalau saat malam hari efektivitas memikirkan konsep dan segala macam itu sedikit sulit. Namun ya Okay. Alhamdulillah, walaupun tidak benar-benar scripted, kita benar-benar membahas secara matang konsep dan alur utama yang akan kita tampilkan gitu, Ibu.
Oke. Jadi benar-benar impromptu gitu ya kalau untuk speech-nya. Jadi dikembangkan sendiri-sendiri, tapi konsep dan alur itu direncanakan. Is that right in short? Okay, good.
Betul, Ibu.
Luar biasa.
Jadi ya sokoknya gimana kalian gitu mau ngomong apa gitu, but this is the plot, this is the scenario gitu.
Okay. Alright, I see. Very good. And then, what do you feel nih? What do you feel? Do you think that your performance today is better than the previous one? If yes, why? If no, why not? Coba. Ayo, Miss Ramadanti or Miss Ramadlani, you both are twins. Ya, gimana? Do you think is it better? It is better or worse? If yes, why? If no, why not? Coba.
I think it's better than before.
Mm-hmm.
Because the concept is really pretty well. Kayak ngekonsepinnya emang benar-benar karena ya matang banget gitu. Jadi pas waktu pelaksananya juga alhamdulillah lancar ya, walaupun mungkin ada beberapa teman yang mungkin terkendala sama jaringan kayak gitu. Mungkin kayak gitu sih, Bu.
Iya. Betul. Ya, memang kalau jaringan itu hal yang di luar kuasa kita ya, teman-teman. Ya, tapi luar biasa, ini sudah well prepared secara konsep dan pengembangan skrip itu secara individu. Hasilnya, alhamdulillah, meskipun Pak Ridwan Kamil ini ngomongnya masih sedikit banget, Pak Ridwan. Rizal Al-Kamil maksud saya. Okay. Ini tapi bajunya udah bagus banget dan dipakai peci, luar biasa, Pak. Wah, Pak. Kayak ini ya, Bupati Tasikmalaya dulu yang sekarang jadi wakil gubernur.
Pak.
Siapa itu? Iya, Pak UU. Betul. Nggak apa-apa, calon bupati masa yang akan datang, Pak Kamil ya. Oke, ya luar biasa sekali lagi give applause untuk kelompok ini ya. Semoga penampilan-penampilannya yang lain lebih menginspirasi dan semoga menjadi guru masa depan ya, yang tentunya penuh dengan data ya, yang penuh dengan evidence ketika akan mengambil suatu decision. Itu sangat bagus sekali. Well, thank you so much for Minerva group members. Okay.